Organizers say the Youth Entrepreneurship Program lived up to its promise to be the best of its kind. Given the unemployment situation, the government of Taiwan, in conjunction with the government of St. Lucia and the Sir Arthur Lewis Community College, decided to invest in the initiative. For many of the participants, it's their first experience in showcasing. In just a matter of 3 months, many of the youngsters moved from conceptualizing their ideas to having their products on supermarket shelves.
We know that normally the health of a nation depends on entrepreneurship, so we're trying to create that entrepreneurial avenue for the young people. Some of them have brilliant ideas, but they didn't have a place to hone it, they didn't have a place to test their concept, they didn't have a place to get their labeling and so forth right, and we created a program to do that. So the program wasn't just about giving run-of-the-mill courses, but it was actually helping them to prototype and also to network to get their products out there and in the supermarkets. Some of the people we have here today already have their stuff in the supermarket. So I think so far it is doing what we had set out for it to do.
The course covered areas like social media marketing and accounts, among a host of others. And the program is not confined to students of the Sir Arthur Lewis Community College. Anyone with a viable business idea and the commitment to go with it can come forward and register.
So the program was open to everybody. We were not stringent in terms of asking for this amount of CXEs. You could come from any background, any location. It was island-wide we advertised. So once you have entrepreneurial aspirations, you have the zeal, you have the commitment, we'll make entrepreneurs out of you. We're not excluding anybody.
Meet Solange Martelli. Her family-owned business manufactures CMOS products. For her, quality assurance is the order of the day. In just 1 year of operation, the business has rapidly progressed to certification and has already begun exporting its products. This is in keeping with a call by Agriculture Minister Alfred Prosper to small and medium enterprises to get certified in keeping with international standards.
I totally agree with him, and that is why we have taken the steps to become certified in all the ways that we can. Of course, we're going to continue trying to improve, but we are officially certified, which is why we're able to supply the supermarkets and to export internationally as well.
Kimberly King is the proud owner of Kim's Wrap. She started her business after being laid off. That's when the idea to start her healthy fast food business came to her. So she came up with her organic signature sauces.
I was kind of laid off from work, and the only resources I had in my refrigerator was vegetables. So I said, St. Lucia is becoming a place of fast food. So I wonder, why not promote healthy, make it healthy fast food? So then I came up with my signature sauces, Kim's lemon creamy sauce, that's for fish, and I also have Kim's delish avocado. I made this with avocado and Greek yogurt. And we also have sweet baby sauce, that's similar to Thousand Island. Yes, so I came up with this idea because I just want to promote local. All my vegetables are strictly organic, and in due time, I would love to have my own farm so I could promote the healthy style.
King is working on getting certified and in time hopes to export her products. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.